And we're going to do a little review over the positions. So to begin with, we're going to start with this inside part of the eyebrow. The fingers of the customer should be positioned right under the brow bone of the area that you're planning to work on. The other hand is going to be positioned directly in front of it or directly opposite of it. That way it'll hold it. You don't want to move it too down because you could potentially stretch the skin. And you don't want to put it too high because it will interfere with you. As you move along, you will place the hand under the area you will be working with the top hand directly across from it, until you move on to the tail and you continue on. To get the arch, it's very important that you position the fingers exactly where they need to be. You want the customer to hold the skin firm and tight, not so much as to stretch the skin out or to jiggle it to the sides, because then you lose control and you lose sight of the arch. If the customer were to place his hand here, the skin is stretched out and then the arch wouldn't be made correctly. So you want them to place it, you know, just tight enough that they can sustain it without moving the arch around or changing the shape. To make the perfect shape, you have to know what the customer wants. This portion right here where she has the thread on, you're gonna wanna hold it straight. Same as in this portion, you're gonna want it straight as well, straight across so that you can pluck the hair. And also on the bottom, you also wanna maintain the straightness on that side and on the inside of the tail. For the arch part, the tricky part, you wanna slowly arch the thread. You don't want to do it too fast so that you get that perfect arch. You don't want it to come out like an inverted C shape. You want to not take too much hair off the end. That's why we maintain the straightness so we get that long tail-like feature. Okay, the middle part is also very important. You want the thread to be straight across. You don't want to curve it, and you don't want a big gap either. Ideally, you would like to follow the lines of the nose bone. Take off only a little bit portion so the nose continues getting that long and elongated look. You're gonna put one portion, you're gonna tighten it in between your teeth, and then the second portion, you're gonna wrap it around your hands multiple times to create this little area right here of tightened string. The eyebrow hair is gonna go in this loop right here. You must be very careful. Whatever goes in here will be taken off. So it's very important that you do it slowly and take your time to get the shape that the customer desires. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna slide the string towards the left in order to trap in there the hair that we want to remove in the loop. Then we're gonna move it to the right to actually remove the hair. So as you see, it's first to the left to trap it, separate it, and then to the right to remove the hair, all while maintaining it straight and doing it slowly, taking her time as to not mess the arch up. So as we said before, we're going to hold the skin tightly as to not stretch it out directly in front of each other. Yeah.